I'm very excited to see the film. I have read the book when I was in college in New York. That is one of the first books that I read as I joined college. And it was a very impressionable time in my life. And I have some things have retained in my heart from this autobiography. And it's one of the important books, you know, that one has come across. And I'm going to reread the book now that Sushmita Mukherjee has gifted the book to me again. And I look forward to rereading it, because now after that many years, how is it going to impact me now? What am I going to make of it now? And his life is, of course, something that needs to be seen by everyone.
Fabulous. You know, it's a real, it's, I would say, a rude awakening in many ways, because, you know, we always like to ape people from the West, you know, and it's a very humbling feeling when you have a master from our part of the world, you know, and an Eastern master when it comes to his philosophy, who became a giant going across to the West and conquering the Western world as early as the turn of the, 19th century, the 18th century. It's a very humbling experience. It shows that there is a part to self-realization, and some of the techniques, which you see in the movie and which are spoken about is quite unbelievable. You know, people say, you know, that you live in the modern day and age you experience a life of materialistic stuff, artificial stuff. You know, you really don't hit reality the way it should. But I'm sure when you watch this film, you know, nothing is impossible. If you can practice those techniques, you will realize the path to self-realization. You know, there's also a saying always said, live in the now. What is the now? It is reality. When you keep getting a reality check, you will know how to live in the now and not think too far ahead, not think too far behind. But sir, fantastic movie. I thought the best part, which I said later on, was how a man, a human being, you know, just with a relationship, you know, like a guru shishya relationship, both them, you know, through a relationship with his guru, Yukteswarji, could travel that far, you know, single-handedly into the United States with nothing in hand, no baggage whatsoever, and then conquer the West just on sheer self-belief and the power of self-realization. Unbelievable.
Well, I'm really going to catch it again in the cinema hall on the 17th of June. I want to see it with everybody there of the public. I'm very grateful a film like this has been made. I think it's very important that this sort of energy we put out into the world that we are living in today, a spiritually charged energy that comes from a great realized human being, is something we all need more than ever today, you know. Because the world is just being, and especially through the medium of cinema, which is the great, the biggest, the most powerful medium of entertainment and of reaching out to people. So it's just so, so lovely that Yoganand ji pe ek film ban rahi hai aur wo ab cinema halls mein aayegi. And he has been a great spiritual power for the West for all these years. It's a pity that we haven't followed him as powerfully and as passionately, but hopefully things will change. And we really need this sort of energy coming into our space today, our space of the world. Very, very necessary.
Ma'am, it's an arts and biography, so do you think a life of yogi can create a magic on box office?
Yes, I think so. You know, the interesting thing is that somebody like Steve Jobs used to read the autobiography of a yogi every year. And apparently when he passed away, copies of autobiography of a yogi were distributed to people at his funeral. You know, I know a lot of the greatest filmmakers, the most successful Hollywood filmmakers, have studied the autobiography of a yogi like a Bible every year. If nothing, at least people who are commercially inclined very much in the material world can realize that there is a balance between materiality and the spirit. And you can't kill the spirit in search of materiality, otherwise that all the riches of the world mean nothing if you're spiritually not realized. नहीं, आप योगा को ट्रेंड नहीं बोल सकते हैं। ट्रेंड हाँ, ट्रेंड लोग बोलते हैं क्योंकि जो नहीं पता फिर को लगता है कुछ खास लोग उसको फॉलो कर रहे हैं तो वो ट्रेंड है। लेकिन जो लोग योगा करते हैं उनके लिए वो एक बहुत गहरी आत्मदर्शन है, जिसे कहते हैं अभिमुख होना अपने आप से, सम्मुख होना। तो ये ट्रेंड नहीं कह सकते योगा को। जिसने योगा का पथ पकड़ लिया वो भाग्यशाली है, जिसने नहीं पकड़ा उसे कुछ जन्म लेने पड़ेंगे समझने के लिए कि मैं कौन हूँ, क्या हूँ, कहाँ से आया और क्यों आया हूँ और आगे कहाँ जा रहा हूँ। The urban needs it even more because urban people are so disconnected with the nature, they're disconnected with their own bodies, they're disconnected with each other. Husbands don't connect to wives, wives don't connect to husbands, their husbands, respective husbands I mean. Children, parents, everywhere where you see today the malaise of urban life is a deep disconnect, first of all with yourself, and naturally when it's with yourself then you are disconnected with every other human being around you. So I think the urban needs a spiritual connect more than people who are you know, happily living closer to nature.
I've seen parts of it and I was in and out attending to other matters as well. Shuru ka dekha, ant ka dekha, aur abhi to bahut baar dekhna hai kyunki ye mere bhi guru maharaj hain. To abhi to bas dekhna hi dekhna hai is movie ko. We are so happy finally this movie has released. We are also learning so much about our guru, and it's always uplifting and inspiring to see him and to see all the work he has done.
Obviously, it's an arts and a film on a yogi biopic. So, do you think any creator magic on box office or create impact on a personal life?
This movie, Awake, The Life of Yogananda, is a very deep and very spiritual movie. It will appeal to the masses as well because of the International Day of Yoga. And Paramahansa Yogananda was one of the greatest yogis who took this message of yoga to the West. He's called the father of yoga in the West. So I'm sure on this day of yoga, everybody will appreciate this movie. And those who are questioning or searching will certainly find answers here, as I have and all of us have.
How
many of you have been a Guru Ji? How many of you have been a Guru Ji? I'm a big fan of Guru Ji. Actually, I've been a long Canada se India, dhoonte ki sach kya hai. सच क्या है, मैंने कनाडा में फ़िलासफ़ी पढ़ा था फिर भी सेटिस्फेक्शन नहीं मिला, इंडिया में आके भी फ़िलासफ़ी पढ़ा, अष्टांग योग मिला, यम नियम आसन प्राणायाम, फिर भी समझ नहीं आ रहा था कि मुझे करना क्या है। जब गुरुजी की पुस्तक मैंने पढ़ी, ऑटोबायोग्राफी ऑफ अ योगी, तो मैंने कहा अब समझ आया, एटलीस्ट गुरु चरण मिल गए, उसके बाद सब अपने आप हो जाएगा। योगा सिर्फ आसन ही नहीं है, अष्टांग योग बोलते हैं, एट फोल्ड पाथ, यम नियम आसन प्राणायाम प्रत्याहार धारणा ध्यान समाधि। तो हमें सिर्फ आसन पे नहीं रुकना है, हमें ध्यान भी करना है और समाधि तक पहुंचना है, मतलब सुपर कॉन्शियस ब्लिस। सो मेडिटेशन इज़ द रियल पर्पस ऑफ योगा, और जितना हम प्रैक्टिस करेंगे तो आनंद ही आनंद है, उसमें कोई लिमिट नहीं है।
I just watched the film.
So how was the film?
Where am I supposed to look? So, I think it was a very moving experience, and for somebody like me who's always been surrounded by a lot of devotees, I'm not myself a devotee and a follower as yet, but there was something that moved inside me when I saw the film, because it makes me wonder, there has to be something really solid that years after he was born and years after his existence, people are still talking about it, not just in a small village, a group of 100 people, it's countless people now spread across the globe, and it's so overwhelming to see what that man could do just based on his willpower, his faith, his belief, his constant inquisitiveness about seeking peace, and I've known of how many ever people who are the devotees, like really close friends of mine. They start their day or pick up the phone and say Jai Guru. And there have been times when I've wondered, why? You can say hello, yeah. But now I do understand that there's no blank reason why they just blindly follow the man himself. But there is a solid learning that has gone into them becoming devotees, and I hope to read more about it. It's been a very splendid, incredible day for me. In fact, my husband was reading a book on him some 4 days back, and then a friend of mine who's a devotee invited us to the screening, and he was telling me about, oh, I'm starting to read this book. Maine ek saal pehle kharidi thi. And it's how, like so many powers come together to get you to do something. The next morning he opened that envelope, which was the invite, and it had the same book. So it was very shocking, and maybe it's just a sign, it's a message that now maybe even I should start reading about it, and the next time I talk to you, maybe even I'm following the path.
So any plan to do?
It's not a story that isme best part lagega. It was a whole experience, it was like a journey, I think, for not just me but everybody who's seen the movie.
So any plan to become a yogi?
Anyway, plan to become a yogi? It's I don't know. It's not like you get to hear about something and next morning you start doing yoga and meditating. My husband does a lot of meditation. I think it's these kind of messages, they just happen to you. And so maybe the wave takes me with it someday soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
ये फिल्म नहीं है मेरे लिए, ये जीवन की एक जर्नी है, क्योंकि मैं योगदा सत्संग से पिछले 9 साल से जुड़ी हुई हूँ. मैं साधक हूँ और गुरुजी की टीचिंग्स में हम लोग पढ़ते हैं, हम वीकली सत्संग में जाते हैं. तो ये मेरे लिए फिल्म नहीं है, ये मेरे लिए कुछ और ही है. कि
So why do people believe in him? Because we have saw that Ashram Babu has come up with such bad thing. So do you think it will create a magic on a box session in the people life?
See, because everybody says their guru is the best, but I know my guru is an avatar. Avatar is what? A descending from God himself. Avatara, ऊपर से जो नीचे आता है भगवान के रूप में, वो अवतार है. सो योगानंद जी इज़ एन अवतार एंड ही हैज़ डन ऑल हिज वर्क एंड एज अ मैन उन्होंने बहुत स्ट्रगल भी किया, जैसे पिक्चर में दिखाया है. और जहाँ तक ये सब आश्राम बापू जब अगरज की बातें हैं, ऐसे बहुत लोग मिलेंगे, अच्छे भी बुरे भी. आपका नसीब है, आपके कर्म है कि आपको कौन से गुरु या कौन से ऋषि या कौन से टीचर या कौन से माँ बाप, कौन सा हस्बैंड, कौन से बच्चे आपको मिलेंगे, आपके कर्म और आपके जर्नी के हिसाब से मिलते हैं.
सो डू यू थिंक दिस फिल्म कैन एनलाइट द पीपल?
आई डोंट थिंक, आई नो द टाइम इज राइट फॉर दिस फिल्म टू हैपन एंड दैट्स व्हाई द फिल्म इज हैपन. दिस वर्ल्ड नीड्स दिस फिल्म, दिस वर्ल्ड नीड्स फॉर अस टू बी अवेक एंड इट इज गुरुदेव हिमसेल्फ हु इज मेकिंग इट पॉसिबल. जब अब के देखिए आप, बहुत बहुत मुश्किल टाइम आने वाला है. 2017-18 में थर्ड वर्ल्ड की पॉसिबिलिटी है, बहुत सारी चीज़ें. इस टाइम पे ये एक बहुत बड़ी बीकन ऑफ लाइट लेके आएगी ये फिल्म, क्योंकि मेरे जो मित्रगण आए, वो देखने आए, वो मुझे बोल रहे कि तुम्हारे सत्संग में मुझे जाना है. ये छोटी सी बीज है जो एक बहुत बहुत बड़ा इसका बनेगा. स्क्रीन में तो मैं रोज़ नज़र आती हूँ, टेलीविज़न में आती हूँ, पिक्चरों में आती हूँ, मैं तो हर दूसरे दिन आती हूँ.
Thank you.